Check your volume, because this thing is about to roll. Oh, this thing is on. Hey, look at that. Episode 3. Hot off the press. All right. It's not even a press. Look, it's just hot. It's fresh. That's what we're talking about. Anyway, it's episode 3. I would just like to say right off the bat, my shows can be full of spoilers, sometimes not. So I just want to put the disclaimer in there that if you haven't seen what I'm talking about, then I would suggest shutting it off. Because I try not to give out spoilers at times, and other times I would hate to slip and spoil something for you. It happened to me once. Well, actually a couple times. It doesn't happen once, right? It happened once. That's a fluke. But I hadn't seen Braveheart. And, like, I think the night it was released, a friend of mine, she's talking about it, and she's going on. Now, mind you, I don't know the story of Braveheart, but the movie looked really cool, and Mel Gibson's pretty kick-ass. So, she's talking about the movie, and then she's like, it's too bad he dies at the end. That dead silence you just got, I was like, what the heck? So, I was a bit sad that something was given away, but I was like, you know, I'm still going to go see this. So, I went and saw it. The whole time I'm watching the movie, I'm like, maybe she was messing with me. How can you take this guy out? And then, of course, the movie ends, and I was pretty torn up. Still, I loved it so much, I went and saw it the next day again and enjoyed it. But, yeah, spoilers. I try not to spoil anything, but caution. Just, you know, safety. If you haven't watched it yet, or, you know, if you don't mind spoilers, then go ahead and keep listening. I did just get back from seeing Overlord. I don't think I can spoil this. So, man, better than expected. I had a good time. I really enjoyed it. There was only one other person in theater with me. I was like, dang it. Could have been the only person again, but I wasn't. Again, I wasn't expecting much going into this. You know, it looks like a war movie, but there's some horror. And I like war horror movies. Like, it's World War II. And I like when they take true facts of history.
We shall never surrender.
As best as we can, you know, guess. And meld it with fiction. Like, you know, because this was going on during the war. So I thought the acting was great. It was gritty. It was bloody. It was a war movie and elements of horror. I'm leaning more towards war and that war is scary, so it can be a horror. But there are a couple other movies that I've seen that I've really enjoyed that I didn't see them in the movie theaters because I don't even know. I think they were just like one of those straight to DVD type things. Death Watch, that came out in 2002. That one kind of caught me by surprise. I was like, this is back when you could read, you know, the little back of the DVD box and be like, man, this sounds cool. So you check it out. And I really enjoyed it. It's around World War I. It came out in 2002. So it's a squad of British soldiers. They come across a complex and then, you know, it just kind of goes downhill from there. And names in it, Andy Serkis is in it. If you don't know who he is, then I don't even know why we're talking. Jamie Bell, who was from Billy Elliot fame, which came out in 2000, is also in it. But I suggest you check it out if you like horror films and stuff with war and stuff. Death Watch is cool. There was another one that came out the same year that surprised me too, Below. This one is directed by David Tui, who did like Chronicles of Riddick, Riddick, Pitch Black, stuff like that. Also has Zach Galifianakis, which when I watched it at the time, I didn't know who he was. But looking back now, this one's based in World War II. It also came out in 2002. I'll have it in the show notes. But Below and Death Watch, another on my radar that I just saw the trailer to while we're talking about horror, World War I, World War II is what I would say. Trench 11. Again, I'll have that trailer in the show notes. Looks creepy as fuck. I don't like worms coming in and out of your nose. And it looks fantastic. So check that one out. And if you know of anything that's cool that you're like, Pat, you got to see this. Again, hit me up. But jumping back to Overlord, because it's J.J. Abrams' Bad Robot production, as I'm watching it, I'm thinking, is this based in Cloverfield like timeline, stuff like that? I've only seen Cloverfield. I haven't seen the other two yet. I get busy, so I can't keep up, but I'm really curious. So after reading they're saying, no, it's not. It's a standalone movie. It has nothing to do with that. And also, when the credits roll, there's nothing after. I can save you some time there. You don't have to wait for it, unless you just like sit through it and seeing all that and listen to the music and stuff. So it's just a standalone movie. Can it have a sequel? Of course. How could it not? And the, you know, they can always tie up loose ends, but I would say there's some loose ends that aren't tied up. Just how it ended. Not giving anything away. Because I like jumping back and forth with Discord Accords, listening to them and kind of giving my feedback on some stuff they're talking about. Steven was talking about, and Jonathan, they were talking about werewolves and movies and stuff like that, and how The Howling was pretty freaky for Steven. It was top of his list as far as a scary movie to watch with werewolves and stuff. And the whole time he's talking, I was thinking, I don't remember The Howling too much. I seen it a long time ago. I've seen it once. The one that sticks in my mind and scared the living daylights out of me as a kid, American Werewolf in London, which they do talk about. That, I believe when I first watched it, I was probably 10 or 11. And I remember sitting with my parents, HBO on, we're watching it. As soon as the transformation scene happens, I'm freaking out. And then I believe what the kicker was when... I can't remember the actor's name, is dead on the couch talking to his other buddy. And I was like, you know, I'm out. A couple of years later, I watched the whole movie and really loved it. It's high on my list as one of the top werewolf movies. Ahead of its time as far as transformation, showing you everything and all that. And it's just freaky. The dream scene is just crazy. I don't like when you're asleep and you dream. And you wake up, but you didn't wake up. It's a dream, and it's even worse than the dream you were having before until you wake up. Freaks me out. American Werewolf in London, great flick. I believe the sequel, American Werewolf in Paris? There's my memory, because you could just erase. You don't have to see that one. But if you like werewolf movies, definitely American Werewolf in London. I just finished up Homecoming. 10 episodes. It's on Amazon Prime. Starring Julia Roberts, and it's based off a famous podcast of the same name, Homecoming, which I haven't listened to yet. I listened to the intro, and I was surprised to hear how many actors are actually doing that podcast. So it's basically like an old-time radio drama, and I used to listen to those a lot as a kid. The Shadow, one of my favorites. I remember listening to The Green Hornet and some others, but The Shadow, one of my favorites. But anyway, back to Homecoming. Really good. The cinematography, the directing, all together, well done. It didn't feel rushed. It answered questions and opens up because there's a second season as the podcast goes. So I'm assuming Amazon is going to move forward and do a second season with this because you want to know more. That's pretty cool. I think my favorite part of the whole thing is the cinematography and the sounds. It's just incredible. I love getting immersed, and that really just drew me in, and I wanted to see more. I love the story too because it was pretty interesting, but on a whole, well put together, the whole show. So check it out, Amazon Prime. If not, and you don't have that, I bet you can listen to the podcast and get the same out of it, just not the visuals. Then you create your own visuals. People talking, you build the world. Well, and they help build you the world. All that. Here's the part I felt like opening up because I find it funny, and I'll call it Pat's Confessional. I love movies. People who know me know I love movies and watch a lot of movies and get immersed in it and have seen a ton. I have missed a few movies over my lifetime, believe it or not, because there are so many. And some people have asked me and wondered, how have I not seen all of The Godfathers?
I'm going to make them an offer he can't refuse.
To tell you the truth, I have no idea. I think about 5 years ago it was, I sat down and watched Godfather, loved it. And then it was late, it was probably 1 a.m, I'm like, I'm starting Godfather 2. I made it, you know, to disc 1 because it's so big, DVD that I had is, you know, part 1 and part 2 of Godfather 2 is like, kind of like Laserdisc, flip it over. Anyway, I was so tired, I didn't want to continue watching because I wanted to not fall asleep on the movie. I have not picked up and finished. I'm halfway through Godfather 2, haven't watched Godfather 3, and that's where we stand right now. Will I ever finish it? I don't know. Do I find what I've seen fabulous? I do. It's hard. You got to be in the mood. Kind of like, I love the Rocky series. Some of them are crap. Some of them are great. I haven't seen Creed, and it's been on my radar. I've wanted to see it. It just haven't taken the time to see it. Then, of course, now Creed 2 is out. I've seen the trailer for it, and I'm like, oh my God, how have I not seen Creed? I gotta see it before I see Creed 2 because, well, if you've seen the trailer, you know who's in it. That's what kind of sparked me to get interest in it again and stuff. You get behind, don't you? I mean, hasn't there been stuff you've been like, man, I need to see this, and then you just don't, or you don't have time, and not that I forgot about it, it's just I haven't taken the time. I do tons of things. I try to stay the course, but sometimes my train takes off on a different track and head down that way. But now that Creed 2 is out, I gotta see Creed. And this week, what's in my coffee cup? It's from Black Rifle Coffee Company. Silencer smooth. Just like it sounds. Smooth. I'll link you up in the show notes. Go check them out. There are a ton of blends to choose from. Another one I do like is Blackbeard's Delight. Caffeinated as fuck is pretty good, but high on my list, Silencer Smooth, Blackbeard's Delight, the two that I keep going back to. If you're looking at tech, sometimes it involves bags, straps, stuff to carry said tech. When I'm rolling with my camera, some stuff that I really love is Peak Design. They make, in my opinion, the best camera strap for your camera. They come in three different sizes, depending on what camera you're lugging with you, and I love all of them. I will toss some links in the show notes again so you can check them out. The bags, I love to death. The function, how they work, and just seamlessly seem to have everything together and thought everything through. And then anytime they come up with like a new version, it's even better and built upon what they already have. But I can't say enough about the camera straps because that's where I started. That was my gateway to Peak Design. I was like, I've gone through like four types of straps. I've looked at some and I'm like, I don't like the price of that. It doesn't seem like you're going to get a good deal and so on and so forth. So I dropped the coin on the Peak Design and I never looked back. It conforms to your body, feels great, hooks up perfectly. You can unhook at the drop of a dime if you need the strap off. You can hook back up, comes with plates that you can get that you can hook into your tripod, and it just all around functions and fits my lifestyle. But I thought I'd share that with you because who doesn't like a good camera strap? Everybody loves a good camera strap. I even see people using the stock camera straps that come with the Nikons and the Sonys and stuff. And you know what? If it works for you, stick with it. If you're looking for something new, fresh, and cool, and functions, and lifetime guarantee, Peak Design. Check them out. Seriously. It's not that I'd steer you wrong. I just want to point you in the right direction. Music. Well, I'm still listening to what I've been talking about, among some other things. Today, cruising through YouTube, as I usually do, I'm like, what's new? Flipping around, scrolling, getting some of my little bits and pieces of this and that, and then all of a sudden I see Def Leppard. Personal Jesus. I'm like, get out of here. I click it, blown away. Such a great job. Of course, I wasn't thinking Def Leppard could botch it, because I really love Def Leppard. I've always loved Def Leppard. And find their story interesting, and the band on a whole, they all seem like a great group. I mean, I remember hearing Pyromania and wearing that vinyl out as a kid, and then the drummer losing his arm, then we lose Steve Steeman Clark, and then Vivian Campbell is back. I believe the cancer is in remission, or they got it. I haven't followed up too much on it, but they're back. It's an amazing cover. Check it out. The video gets a few hits because people are like, wow, look at how old they are, blah, blah, blah. Of course, they've been around for a long time. And they still bring it. That's the beauty of this whole thing. So that's something I really found to be cool today. Not this week because I just found it today. But it's still stuck in my brain. Maybe it'll get stuck in yours, but they do it right. It's pretty cool to see them do a Depeche Mode song. Of course, everybody's like, oh, you can't beat the original. Duh. So there you go. Of course, where will it be? In the show notes, Pat. Of course, while we're on the audio side of talking and stuff, and, you know, the part where I like to be like, hey, you should check this podcast out. Harlan Williams, I can't say enough about this guy. He's bizarre. He's funny. He's right up my alley. I never really knew who he was until I watched Rocket Man because it looked funny. And, well, it's one of my top comedies of all time. It's hilarious if you like some whacked out humor. And, of course, I was going to call him Fred because that's his character in the thing. Fred Randall.
Astronaut Fred Randall.
Harlan brings it. I wish they had done a sequel. I don't know why they didn't, because it's pretty hilarious. So if you haven't seen it and you want to know why he looks like a blueberry or a Smurf, you should watch it. If you've seen the movie, you'll get that. But anyway, Harlan Williams has a podcast, which, hey, I only found that a few months ago. It's called The Harlan Highway. You can get it on iTunes. And I believe you should be able to find it on other platforms. But I'll link his website there for you. But hilarious. He has quite a few comedy albums out too, which are pretty bizarre funny. So again, if you like strange comedy that makes you sometimes think, because he does that, it's pretty hilarious. And if you've ever like seen a few of his shows or whatever, which you just hit YouTube, he's pretty funny to even just watch, because his facial expressions and body language really help sell the comedy too. But even just listening to him, just thinking about it makes me laugh. I mean, that's pretty cool, right? Having a downer day, be like, think of Harlan Williams and some of his comedy, get you smiling. I don't know. I get lost for words sometimes, and then I just stumble all over my words. So as long as you keep following, we'll keep going forward. But if you stop to pause and listen to what I've really said, maybe you won't quite get what I've really said. But what I'm saying is, Harlan Williams, The Harlan Highway, I'll have the links up for you. You can check that one out. It's a pretty funny podcast, and it's pretty much just him. So being Harlan Williams. I started with TV. Why don't we roll out and finish it with some TV. Actually, I started talking about movies and spoilers, didn't I? Are you paying attention? Because I'm not. Oh, but anyway. I've been watching Survivor the past few years. I started getting into it with my wife, Allison. She used to watch it, and then we met, and she was watching it, and all of a sudden I got sucked in. There's the short story long. Actually, it's long story short, right? I don't know. Something like that. But anyway, all I can really say is it's been a fabulous season so far. Looking forward to the next episode, and which I think might be two or three left before they final it out and, you know, vote on a winner. But if you're looking to check Survivor out, it should be on Hulu after the season's over, because, you know, no sense starting out, because then you'll find out how it ends unless you don't care. Unless you don't care about spoilers. But talking about spoilers, and hopefully you're caught up on Walking Dead, this season has definitely stepped it up. I'm so happy with how it's going. It's still not, you know, one of their greatest, but they seem to picked up themselves, dusted themselves off, and started writing how the show should be going and everything and flowing. Because the past few seasons, if you ask me, have really sucked. I haven't enjoyed it. I've watched it just to keep going with the show because I'm invested. And you know, you always have that hope that the show you love is going to pick itself back up and get going again. Because I understand getting stalled and all that. But, excuse me. all that excitement. Maybe I should slow down so I don't sound like I'm all jacked up on caffeine. The mid-season finale happened. And, thank you. I would say a good group of fans have been wanting something like that. You're asking what? Can I give spoilers? It's not really a spoiler, but the whispers have showed up. Who are they? Good question. That's all I'm going to tell you. But looking like it's going to start picking up again I'd say you can jump back in if you stopped watching and catch yourself up. I guess it's time for me to check out, get rolling with my other day, because I have more than just this to do, believe it or not. I mean, I probably could sit all day and just talk, but I don't want you to get bored. I want you to have a good time. If you want to hit me up with any questions, comments, feel free to leave some comments. You can email me, whatthepatpodcast@gmail.com. Feel free to share your thoughts and what you're listening to if you want, or just send out a hi. Be nice to know who's listening, because I do appreciate you listening. Even if it's just one person, that's two more ears I've reached. Have a good one. Enjoy it. And drink coffee. You can get it on U-Tunes. U-Tunes.